an investment in knowledge pays the best interest. Benjamin Franklin. Chapter 9, Investing in Your Life. The most important investment you can make is in yourself. Warren Buffett. I know a woman who struggled with her weight all of her adult life. She really wanted to lose the weight, but needed a support system to get it done. I recall talking to her about places like quick weight loss centers and Nutrisystem because I knew of other women who had terrific success with their programs. She would tell me that she couldn't afford it. If only she could join a gym and hire a personal trainer. But again, she couldn't afford it. As she got older, her knees began to give her trouble and her hips began paining her. Later, she developed high blood pressure and type 2 diabetes. It was tough to watch because she was sincere in her earnest desire to change, but she needed a support system and couldn't seem to find the extra money for any of the things she knew would work. Her daughter was overweight like she was, and at age 15 developed diabetes and high blood pressure. Furthermore, she was being seen by a cardiologist because they were concerned she had developed a heart condition. My friend was devastated. She loved her daughter deeply and felt responsible for her medical problems. Determined not to allow her daughter to regress further, she found the money for her daughter and herself to join Weight Watchers. She also enrolled them at a gym in her area. She began getting up at 5 a.m. and going to the gym before school and work. They both began to eat better and motivated one another. My friend no longer takes medication for her diabetes or hypertension. Neither does her daughter. They have collectively lost 170 pounds and are not stopping. This story is interesting to me because I am amazed how quickly my friend seemed to find the money when she feared her daughter's prognosis was bleak. This same woman, for years, spoke of her dreams of going to the gym and joining a weight loss program. But she said over and over she could not afford to do so. She even told me she could not afford to eat healthy. I believe she really believed that. I don't think for a moment that she was using her lack of finances as an excuse. But what is remarkable is how, without a new job, new husband, winning the lottery, or other life-altering episode, she was able to make her daughter's health a priority, and the money followed. My friend's story is not unique. People make choices like that all the time. We say we cannot afford to invest in ourselves. We cannot afford the class, the conference, the books, the memberships. The list goes on and on. But the truth is, we simply are not a priority in our own lives. Because if we were, we would find the money. I want you to imagine going to the bank today and giving the teller $10,000. Imagine going back in 2 years and realizing you hadn't gained one penny in interest. What would you think of the bank? I'm pretty certain you'd take your money out of that bank. You would never expect to invest in a bank and then get back exactly what you gave them. If you want your life to yield more, you have to be willing to invest in your life. And the truth is, it's not possible to get back exactly what you give. Banks may fail, markets may drop, but if you invest in you, you will get a greater return. I'm sure there are a host of classes you could benefit from, but it will require your investment. Perhaps you need to have your teeth fixed to make you more marketable. It will require your investment. Maybe you need to upgrade your wardrobe, invest in a weight loss program, or maybe pay the fees to become part of that business or trade group. Go ahead and pay the price now, because ultimately you will pay the price one way or the other, either on the front end or the back end. If you invest in your health by eating better and losing weight, you pay less on medication, doctor's visits, and days out of work. Paying the cost of return to school will increase your earning power by at least $25,000. I challenge you to redirect your thinking. Rather than asking yourself if you can afford the price, write down the price and ask if you have more value than the dollar figure. For example, if you need $3,000 to have your teeth fixed, You have to complete this sentence. I, your name, deem that I am worth X amount of dollars. What amount goes in the blank? Are you worth $3,000? When you write down the figure, the amount, you discover it looks ludicrous to suggest you may not be worth X dollars. My friend, who found money to invest in her daughter's health, never considered that her daughter wasn't worth the price. After many years of saying with my mouth, I am worth it, yet living a contrary truth, I have come to the conclusion that I do not possess enough money to equal the value of my life and the value of my future success. I am worth far more than I could earn or borrow, and so are you. You have to begin to live a life that supports that very truth. The truth of what you believe is found in your check register and your bank statements. I can surmise what you value based on where you spend your money. I can further surmise what your priorities are by where you invest your time, your talent, and your financial resources. If you are going to rewrite your success story, your name must be on the top of your list of priorities.